types of shops, my favorite topic.
So we're moving into shopping now is a pretty good leeway, I think, actually.
Yeah, no, like, the variety of shops here are, it's amazing. Like, my favorite, like, I've been here, like, nearly 2 months now, and a highlight of my time here is when I was able to go into a shop, a shoe shop, specifically, and point out, I was like, my favorite sentence, so I want that one, please.
I have heard this woman say more times than I think even Chinese people have heard that phrase.
Like, it's really good, like, because you can put that sentence into anything. So I walked in, I was like, and I didn't know my Chinese size, and I just, like, I think like that, I'm pretty sure that's what she asked me, what size are you? And I just looked completely blank at her. So she bent down, picked my foot up, and looked at the sign, and I was like, oh right, the Chinese sides are in like pretty much every shoe. And I was able to buy some shoes, but there were, you know, the shoe shops here, I think I paid for a pretty decent pair of trainers. Like, I paid less than 151, which is pretty good, I think. And
you what brand were they?
New Balance, I think, is the Chinese version of it.
But it was a Chinese brand.
Yeah, they were decent. Oh. So I was like, okay. And they're really comfortable. And I've worn them climbing up various mountains and hills and for class in class and everything. And they're just so comfortable. But yeah, they were so, like, when we go to our local supermarket, the Altima. It's our favourite place in, like, college, you know, I think.
Darren and Fun.
Yes.
I wouldn't say it's our favourite, but it's the place we know the best, for sure.
Oh, yeah. Like, you can go in there and you've got shoe shops, you've got clothes shops, you've got KFC, you've got, what else is there? There's some, like independent sellers, then selling.
Groceries, you've got linens.
Electrics.
Cleaning supplies. Gadgets, gizmos. Think of it as like Walmart.
One stop shop. And it is so, so big. And everyone in the UK now is like your Tesco Extra with like 3-4 times the size of your Tesco Extra. And Tesco Extra is usually kind of 2 floors.
Oh, see, I come from the land of supermarkets, so.
Oh, this.
Like, for me, RT Mart is like normal.
Oh, to me, it's
like that's what I expect from markets.
So if you're in the UK, think of Tesco Extra, but like times it by 4. And Tesco Extra is 2 floors usually. So like, times that by 4, and then you're roughly sort of getting it because there's like a multi-story car park under the ground as well.
Yeah.
So that's pretty cool.
So yeah, that's kind of like our main shop. I've gone, there is also Park 66. There's like a major... There's like a major shopping center. I don't think I've actually ever bought anything from there because I'm like, everything I could buy from here, I could buy like the cheap Chinese knockoff at RT Mart and I'm totally fine with
it. But the cheap Chinese knockoff in China
is really good.
So much better than the Chinese knockoff that you can get imported back home. Like, they like save all their really, really good stuff and keep it themselves. Like, it's so, so good. Like, these shoes are amazing. They're so comfortable.
Yeah.
If I had imported these, they would have fallen apart.
No, I mean, for example, I got a pair of shoes because I came to China with like a nice pair of like dress shoes and then some tennis shoes, but I wanted kind of just like a sort of casual slipper type thing that I can kind of like a light breezy shoe, and I got it for 25 yuan. And apart from the sole that kind of came out. My sole came out. Happens, I'm a ginger. Apart from the sole, like, shifting a little bit every now and then, like, the shoe's been great. I probably wear those shoes now more than I do anything else. It's actually really good for teaching because it's, like, meshy and airy and it weighs, like, negative pounds.
China knows how to do things properly.
Yeah, and even... So one of the things I do want to talk about as far as like imports and exports, and like this is not just the case for shoes, but this is like everything in general. If it's made in China,
it's dirt cheap.
Dirt cheap. If it's imported from anywhere, wicked expensive.
it'd be more expensive and back home.
I say wicked expensive, but it's like, it's just expensive compared to the Chinese, so it's like. But yeah, I guess that's kind of like in general shopping. So like, as a general rule of thumb, if it's made in China, you're gonna know because it's completely affordable. If it's not made in China, you're gonna know because you're gonna be like, why is it so expensive?
But if you buy like imported goods for everything, expect your salary to go.
Yeah.
It's not gonna last.
China is very cheap, but like most countries in the world, the import tax is very, very high.
Yeah, so if you're gonna live off Chinese goods, you'll have so much money at the end of the month.
Yeah, which you can totally do. Chinese goods, like honestly, I haven't been dissatisfied with anything I've bought. There's nothing I've bought in China that I've been dissatisfied with. There's been some things where I'm like, maybe I won't try this again. Or like, you go out, you try a food, and you're like, maybe I won't eat this again. But I'm not dissatisfied with it. It's just kind of like...
Like the
cicadas. I wasn't upset that I ate them. I actually ended up eating like 5 or 6 of them.
Tried one, and I'm happy I've tried it, because I've now done it. But it won't be happening again.
Yeah.
I was told, though, if you eat cicadas, it's good for your skin.
See, everything is about health here. They're always they're very conscious about it all, which is good. It is good.